Hey, how you doing? And welcome. My name is Yannick, and this is my channel, Levec Tech. For my first video, I just wanted to share my home theatre setup and the gear that I've chosen and why. If you're into home theatre, movies, movie soundtracks, or just tech in general, you've come to the right channel. Hopefully this video attracts like-minded people, we'll learn more about my setup, and most importantly, we'd love to know how you've set up your home theatre at home and opinions about my home theatre and various topics in these videos. Soundtrack. For those who don't know, that was a track of Black Hawk Down composed by the one and only Hans Zimmer. Now first off, I just wanted to cover the most important aspect of putting together your own home theatre, and in my opinion, it starts with the room. So I put together a floor plan, and would like to show you what we're dealing with. Assessing the room, in my opinion, is probably the first thing you need to look at, just to get an understanding of the limitations and the acoustics of that room in order to obtain the best possible sound. To make it more challenging, as you can maybe tell, we live in a townhouse, but thankfully I haven't had any issues with noises so far. This is not the ideal room for a home theatre, but this is what we have at the moment, and I didn't want to wait until we moved out. There is barely any echo in the room, so I think it has fairly good acoustics considering the room layout because of the material of the couch and the large canvas behind, I think. But when I watch movies, I can tell audio is lost from the left side being opened. I can't avoid it, so it is what it is. If you're familiar with these, you can tell that I've chosen Klipsch branded speakers. All my speakers are Klipsch. My setup is a 5.1.2 configuration. This is probably the largest config that I'll be able to fit without it looking cluttered or messy with wires or odd positioned speakers. If you haven't noticed, I try to keep things neat and tidy, cables mostly hidden, and keeping things simple. Regarding specs, I've put them in the description below, but please let me know if I've missed anything or if you'd like to know anything further. Reason why I picked this brand is because this is what my ears have loved the past few years. Before this, I had the Klipsch R20B soundbar. When I was doing my research, at the time, I was comparing them with SVS, and even listening to them side by side, my ears still leaned towards Klipsch. Now, this is just a personal preference. To someone else's ears, the SVS may have sounded better, but I'm looking for room-filling sound, sound that I can't tell where the speaker is coming from, and this is what I still find in Klipsch for this type of budget. Now, based on the sound that I was getting from the soundbar, I felt that the 10-inch sub was lacking, and so I knew at a minimum I wanted a 12-inch, and I'm glad that I did. The R112SW fills the room and has a deeper punch in comparison. The 10s are great, don't get me wrong, but naturally these 12s dig deeper and acoustically fill the blanks that the 10s couldn't. I'm pretty happy with my front speakers as they're not too large for the room and they push out clear sound that's satisfying to the ears without putting too much pressure or causing the sound to be muggy or unnatural. Even at high volumes, it's not harsh at all. Again, my room dimensions and acoustics all come to factor when it comes to clear, effortless sound, so my speakers in the correct room I'm sure would sound better than this room, but I'm still happy with the outcome. For my rears, I really wanted the bipole RP240S speakers, but I couldn't because of the room layout. At the time, I wasn't too worried though, but I knew I was looking at smaller speakers as they were going to be closer to the listening position, so I didn't want anything too loud so it drowned out the front speakers. So I got a pair of these that originally came from a 5.1 kit system. Now, I've never had height speakers, so I just went for something that was reasonably priced. I didn't know what to expect, as I've only listened to Atmos speakers in the cinemas or at the display rooms. So it's difficult to know how it's going to really sound like in your room. In saying this, I do wish that I went for the high model, but this is maybe a discussion for another video. Let me know if you want me to go into this further. Powering all these speakers, I have the Denon X3400H. This is a 7-channel amp, so I'm using all the channels so far. I do want to expand down the track, but that will most likely happen when I move out. Main reason why I went for this amp was because after a bit of research, it was a really good combination for my speakers. I also got it at a really good price on Amazon, around $950 I believe, and normally it's around $1,600 at the time. Lastly, I wanted to go over the TV unit and what's controlling all the equipment. I built this TV unit as I wanted something that was off the floor and that was a simple design. Under the TV unit I have the Philips Hue light strip. I also have the Hue bulb in the floor lamp. Controlling all the equipment is the Logitech Harmony Elite. I wouldn't spend $400 on this, but I would highly recommend it. I got it for half the price and I definitely think it was worth half the price. It makes life so much easier to control all the lights and the entire system as opposed to having individual remotes. I know I can go into a lot more detail in this video, but I didn't want to make it too long, and so please let me know if there's anything you want me to go over. There are a couple of videos that I wanted to make moving forward, like the type of cabling that I used and how I installed them, the experience that I had with the height speakers, and the Synology media server that I use for my data and movies, and heaps more. Thank you for watching, and if you liked this video, I really appreciate the support by liking, subscribing, and leaving any questions you have below. See you next time, and take care.